Do you have to flee your country? You might be thinking about coming to Germany, but what would your life look like as a refugee here in this country? Let's have a look together.
This is Ahmed. We will follow him through his experience in Germany. Our fictional character is from Syria. He's 28 years old. He risked his life fleeing his country. He crossed the Mediterranean Sea, didn't sleep for days. Now he's made it to Germany. He's hoping to be granted asylum. This film talks about refugees like Ahmed, who had to flee their country because of war or persecution. They are protected by the German constitution. We're not talking about people immigrating for economic reasons, because that would be a different story. So back to Ahmed. After his arrival, he first has to register as a refugee and apply for asylum. This is likely to take months.
The question is, where is he going to stay in the meantime?
Here in Germany, there are shared accommodations set up for newly arrived refugees.
But what do they really look like on the ground? We went to a small town called Diemelstadt to find out.
This town of 5,000 inhabitants in West Germany has tried to integrate hundreds of refugees in the last years. Immigration reached a new high in Germany with the arrival of more than 1 million Ukrainian refugees. In total, Germany has now registered around 3 million people looking for protection, with an overall population of 84 million. Two of them are Imran Khan and his wife Rubina. They arrived from Afghanistan in April 2022, after the Taliban took over. After their arrival, they were put in here. Shared bathrooms, toilets and showers, shared kitchen. Bachelors and families, door to door.
It is very uncomfortable for my wife, because most of the time, the boys, they're listening to music till morning. They are playing games. They're not concerned with their studies.
For now, the two are happy to be in safety. But they are expecting a baby. This is why they urgently want to move into a private apartment.
Yes.
To be honest, extremely worried for my wife, because this is her first child and the doctors are telling him to have good rest, but she cannot have due to such mixed environment.
But they might get lucky. People from Diemelstadt are helping them to find a private apartment before Rubina gives birth. Also, Ahmed spent many sleepless nights in his shared accommodation. But for him, moving out is not an option yet.
Many people don't realize that most refugees actually are obliged to stay in such shared accommodation while their asylum application is being processed. We met Herbert Brücke, an expert who has been researching the topic of migration for decades and advises the German government regularly. Like many experts in the field, he finds this obligation to stay in shared accommodation controversial.
German asylum policy often thus thinks that herd integration in order to demotivate people from coming to Germany. In these shared accommodations, we have people who live in very close quarters. Often, these places are isolated and have no connection to public infrastructure. This makes learning the language and integrating into the labor market difficult.
Once asylum has been granted, the refugees are allowed to move out of their shared accommodation. But even then, the problems continue. The housing market in Germany is very tight.
Ahmed has to stay in his accommodation for several months until his asylum is granted. In the meantime, he would like to learn German.
Ahmed has good chances to be put in a language course. Let's see what they look like in Diemelstadt.
Macht ihr weiter die Seite, ja?
7, 8, 6.
This group of refugees started their language course a few weeks ago.
Wie heißt ihre Stadt?
Butchina Dombrovsky will teach them for 4 hours every day for 6 to 8 months. German is set to be rather difficult, but Butchina's advice is never give up.
It works. People who don't understand a word today, like what's your name or where are you from, in 2 years' time, suddenly, they speak fluent German.
The teacher of Polish descent knows from personal experience what it means to start over completely.
Ich bin selber
I wasn't born in Germany either. Back then, I took the same path, and look at where I am today. That's why I find learning the language so important. It must be the first step. I get to practice a lot here because everyone speaks German and the people speak standard German.
I like it very much because I am English teacher in profession and foreign languages are not a problem for me.
People here are highly motivated and that will most likely pay off later.
Learning the language is key for getting by, and especially for people who want to stay here permanently. For most of the Ukrainian refugees, it is somewhat different compared to those refugees from Syria or Afghanistan, because they want to stay in Germany permanently. And of course, then they need German language skills.
Good news for Ahmed. As he is a refugee from a war-torn country, his asylum request has been granted. It took several months.
And it could have taken even longer due to European laws. Settle up because this one is complicated. European countries have settled on something which is called the Dublin Regulation. This regulation determines which country is responsible for which asylum application. Here's an example.
Had Ahmed entered the EU from Turkey into Greece, then Greece would have been the first EU country Ahmed set foot in. Therefore, he would be registered in Greece and his asylum request should also be processed there. If he moves on to Germany and asks for asylum there, he will be sent back to Greece.
The Dublin Regulation was installed in 1990 and already back then it wasn't functional, says Herbert Brücker. Still today, the main burden is shouldered by the countries at the EU's external borders.
Right now, the whole thing is concentrated in a few countries that are simply reaching their limits. If we were to distribute people evenly across the European Union, with richer countries taking in more refugees and poorer countries taking in fewer, then we could share the burden fairly.
For years, EU member states have not been able to agree on how to reform the Dublin Regulation.
But at a recent summit, they took the first step to doing just that. EU member states now want to distribute refugees more fairly. But, and this is crucial, they also agreed on something else.
To close the bloc's external borders to hinder people from entering at all.
At every border crossing, each refugee is to be checked for their chances of being granted asylum. For labour migrants who try to cross into the EU for economic reasons, the journey will most likely end here. But people like Ahmed, who face war or persecution at home, will be allowed in, or so the deal promises. With his asylum granted, Ahmed is now looking for a job. His dream is to help the elderly at a care home.
To work in a specific profession in Germany, you will have to get your education recognized. And that is a complicated process because the foreign education has to look exactly like the German one.
Let me give you the example of nurses. In many countries, they go to university and afterwards do work that in Germany only doctors are allowed to do. So if this foreign nurse comes to Germany, she's only allowed to work as a nursing assistant here because she didn't have enough practical coursework in her training.
On a professional level, many refugees therefore have to start over entirely when they come to Germany. For example, working in the construction sector or in restaurants. Around one in three refugees who've arrived since 2015 have officially finished an apprenticeship. Like someone we met in Diemelstadt. Let's have a look.
Musia Bera from Eritrea has found a job at Burkhard Uckel's construction company. He arrived in Germany in 2016 and is now a trained construction worker.
Yes, I like it. That's why I am here on the construction site. At the beginning, it was difficult regarding language, but with time, it got better.
Burkhard Uckel is happy to employ people like Musi. Like many other industries in Germany, the construction sector is suffering a lot from the current shortage of workers.
The refugees help us a lot to do our work and accomplish our goals. It doesn't matter where they come from. The main thing is that they want to work with us, and together we get a lot done.
The worker shortage is a huge problem in Germany. According to a recent study, the country would need around 400,000 migrants each year to keep the economy rolling. Refugees could help alleviate the problem, and there's more.
If you look at the data, one thing is clear. Economies that have greater diversity, that have people from different countries, with different cultural backgrounds, these economies are more productive. Because different people bring different skills and ideas.
So bluntly speaking, it is actually in Germany's own interest to get people into the country. But once here, how easy is it to really settle?
Ahmed now works full-time as a nurse at a retirement home. And he has found a one-bedroom apartment all to himself.
But we all know that there's more to life than just that. So what does it really take to feel like you belong?
Back in Diemelstadt, we are invited to Olad Kasch's home. He fled Somalia 10 years ago and struggled for quite a while before finding his footing.
The first 3 years were so hard. I missed my family. I sometimes dreamt that I was at home, in my country. And then I woke up and I was in Germany. But then, after 3 or 4 years or so, I was only here.
One thing helped. He met Farah. They fell in love and got married. Farah is also from Somalia. Both missed the daily joy and chaos of their big families back home. So what they do is to at least stay in touch with them.
We all have smartphones now, so we can talk with our camera, so we can all see each other.
They can offer their sons the comfort of their own apartment. Olad got a job at a local paper company and pays the rent. And they started exploring local activities. Every Monday, the whole family goes to Diemelstadt Sports Club.
I already feel a bit like I belong in Diemelstadt. The best thing I've seen in Germany is here, in Diemelstadt.
And back home?
I want to see my country doing well one day. That I can go there on holiday with my children, visit it. Now they are still small, but one day they will ask me where they come from, what it looks like. That is going to be difficult for me.
So to sum it all up, what do you really have to expect when coming to Germany as a refugee? We asked our expert for an honest answer.
You have to be prepared for 5 hard years, but eventually it will get better. It's not paradise by any means. The whole thing takes time. As a society, we need patience. But it is above all the refugees who need to have patience. They need it much more.
For those who are allowed and want to stay in Germany, let's hope that the country will one day feel like home.